Good morning, Mustangs, and welcome to the Mustang News in the Morning. I'm Amber Lewis.
And I'm Danny Ramsland. Teachers, if you would like your class to feature in the Daily Pledge segment, please contact Mr. Whitaker.
Teachers and students, are you doing any interesting activity in your third period class? If so, tell anyone on the news staff, and we'll send out the crew, Nate and Nico, to capture the moment.
Seniors, listen up. There's only 30 more spots on the third bus waiting list for Grad Bash. They will not be accepting any other students after that bus is potentially filled. Students need to come by 8:11 or 5:23 to sign up for the third bus waiting list and sign a payment agreement. Senior sponsors would like to have the bus filled by Wednesday. Now let's see what Mrs. Chamberlain has to say in our administration corner.
Hi, I'm Peyton Murchie, I'm the class of 2016 president.
And I'm Allie Chamberlain, the vice president. Last week during Sprig Madness, we had a Skittle guessing contest. The total number of Skittles in the jar was 3,303.
The closest student who guessed 3,300 is Dominic Fumara. Congrats, Dominic.
Now let's see what today's Mega Bites are with Amber.
Today for lunch, you have the choice between a chicken Caesar salad, cheese pizza, or a meatball sub. Don't forget to side your meal with fresh fruits and vegetables. So, did you guys enjoy your pies last Thursday? Here's Michaela with the latest.
With Mustang News in the Morning, and we're in Miss Imperatore's classroom. We're here with Miss Imperatore to talk about Pi Day. Can you tell us what Pi Day is?
Pi Day is a wonderful celebration of how we celebrate the circumference of a circle compared to its diameter. That is a beautiful ratio, which a lot of kids think is just 3.14, but let me tell you, that's a beautiful, irrational number that we mathematicians, algebraists, call pi. And we're celebrating it today, right, everybody?
Yeah.
Woo! Okay.
Now that we know what pie is, let's go see if other kids know. So what do you think pie is?
Dessert.
So what do you think pie is?
Life. And deliciousness.
So what do you think pie is?
3.14.
I'm Michaela Berry, celebrating Pi Day. Back to you guys in the studio.
Today in random news, a swarm of bees disturbed by a tree trimming crew attacked and killed a pit bull. Just outside of North Hollywood, Los Angeles firefighters were called and used mixtures of foam and water to kill the bees. Recently, there has been many bee attacks in California, showing a rise in bee population. In other news, researchers in Australia looked at how much UV protection men's facial hair offered and found that it actually did help. The research involved three mannequin heads while x-rays kept portraying UV light onto them. The heads had different levels of facial hair, and the head with the most actually took less UV radiation, showing facial hair somewhat blocks that UV rays. That's all for random today. Now let's bring it over to Amber and the local area network.
Today in local news, the movie everyone is excited to see, Spring Breakers, has just premiered in LA this weekend. The movie is set to hit theaters very soon. Also, Alicia Keys is performing at the Tampa Bay Times Forum on Sunday. Ticket prices do range and are going fast, so if you plan to go, I suggest getting them now. Now, here's a look at our Spirit Night at Tijuana Flats last week.
I'm Chris Valiant, reporting for the Mustang News in the Morning. I'm here at Tijuana Flats, where I have the Mitchell Fundraiser, where if you mention our school, 10% of the money goes back to us. Let's go check it out.
I'm here with Jake Williams, a cook at Tijuana Flats. And I'm wondering, Jake, how long have you been working here and how do you like it?
I've been working here for about 3 months and I love it. It's my first job, so.
What do you think about Tijuana Flats giving back to the community with the 10% of the proceeds?
I think it's great and it really helps them in the long run.
Do you think it's important for local businesses to give back to schools and other communities in the area?
I think it's great for local businesses to help out. It's really helping out Mitchell.
Thank you, Jake, for your time.
Well,
this has been Christian Blight reporting for the Mustang News of the Morning here at Tijuana Flats for the Mitchell Fundraiser. Back to you in the studio.
Hey guys, it's Carly Dampier here in the Sports Cage. This morning, breaking news, offensive tackle Jake Long signs with the St. Louis Rams on a 4-year, $36 million deal. In NBA news, not surprised that our Miami Heat still has not been stopped, as last night they have won over the Raptors. James had 22 points and 12 rebounds for his career best 32nd double-double of this season. Dwayne Wade had 24 points and 9 assists, and Ray Allen scored 16 of his 20 points. The Heat equaled the second longest winning streak in NBA history, pulling away in the fourth quarter to beat the Toronto Raptors 108-91 for their 22nd consecutive victory. Now it's on to Boston to face the rival Celtics, the team who ended the last streak this long. The updates on our varsity softball team, they are 8-3 aside their two lopsided losses to River Ridge. The Mustangs are 8-1 and have outscored opponents 88-16. Congratulations to the Sexy Squad Night Spiker team on winning their second title in a row. Attention soccer players, all following players must see Coach Whitaker as soon as possible. Chris Benware, Micho Petrovic, and Jesse Zellers. That is all for today. Now let's see what Lucy's up to in our weather app.
Hey Mustangs, it's Lucy Argento here with this week's 5-day forecast. So far it's not looking too good with rain chances every day. Tuesday and Friday is at 30%, with today, Wednesday, and Thursday being at 20%. The highs the next 2 days is at 80 degrees with a low of 63 today and 66 tomorrow. Wednesday there is a high of 78 and a low of 61 degrees with a similar high on Thursday of 77 degrees. Friday is going to be the hottest day of the week with a high of 81 degrees and a low of 65 degrees. Every day is going to be partly sunny out except on Tuesday and Thursday when it will be muggy and cloudy out all day long. That's all for right now, so let's go check out what Nico's up to at today's On Scene Live via Skype.
Thanks, Lucy. I'm Nico Stead reporting live On Scene with Joseph Maroney inside Purple. He's a member of SAD. So I hear something's going on tomorrow in the gymnasium. Can you tell me a little bit about that?
Tomorrow is Unity Day at Mitchell High School, and it's a day where students can get together and do activities to break down stereotypes that usually keep them from becoming friends with each other. And it's an SRA all day, and you get free pizza. So if you're interested, we need more people to sign up, and you can get liability forms from Ms. Viscardi.
So Joseph, you said it's free pizza, and you get out of class all day for hanging out with your friends?
Yep, free pizza all day, making friends.
Well guys, you need to talk to Ms. Viscardi if you want to get a liability form just like this one and turn it in by tomorrow morning. I'm Nico Stead, back to you guys in the studio.
Today's weather photo of the day was sent in by our very own Jason Santori. He took this picture last week while going up a roller coaster at Busch Gardens. It looks like it was about to start pouring out, so thanks for the great photo, Jason. Now let's go see what Amber's up to in the National News link.
Today in national news, Ed Chavez Jr. was feeling pretty grateful last week after his name was drawn from a wicker basket, declaring him the new mayor of the small town of Helper, Utah. After Helper's last mayor, Dean Armstrong, resigned due to being arrested, Chavez and Councilman Kirk Mascaro were deadlocked at 2 votes each, which is when the city council pulled out the wicker basket. It turns out that a little luck goes a long way. In other news, it seems that this past weekend was one for emergency landings. A small plane flying from Opa-locka to Sebring, Florida, had to make an emergency landing onto US Highway 27 after the pilot noticed his windshield becoming covered with oil. Once the engine conked out, he knew he was in trouble but managed to make an easy landing on the highway. Now let's see what the latest campus news is with Danny.
Today in campus news, students, if you want to jack it for your M Mitchell School letter, be sure to check out our website. We have a link that will connect you to the Neff Jacket Shop where you can order one of these jackets. Also, Mustangs, the Harlem Shake video is on YouTube and the school website as well if you would like to see yourself or any of your friends star in our video. Also, a special congratulations to Anthony Pack and Kayla Cencio for winning the honor of Mr. and Mrs. Mitchell for the class of 2013. Thank you for tuning in, Mustangs. I'm Danny Ramslin.
And I'm Amber Lewis.
Her books, her car, her clothes, and a note. But all she wrote was, "Tonight I'm leaving on a train." She said she's in.